Ladies and gentlemen, as our flag comes down midway, would you please rise? Gentlemen, remove your hats. This is our police and fire honor guard. Ladies and gentlemen, could we have a moment of silence in memory of 9/11? Thank you. And now, Forgiven from Risen Savior Lutheran Church.
And bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still. Say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Great job, guys. Great job. Thank you. Thanks for being here. Great job.
Thank you.
Great job, Forgiven from Risen Savior Lutheran Church. How beautiful was that? Let's hear it for our police and fire honor guard. And our cadets, our cadet corps. North Metro Fire Rescue and Broomfield Police Department Color Guard, Honor Guard, Broomfield Composite Squadron Civil Air Patrol, and the Broomfield Police Department Motor Squad, Motorcycle Squad. This is the only time you'll be happy to see them behind you with their sirens and their lights. Metro Fire and Rescue from Station 61, Battalion Chief Engine and Ambulance, and Station 62 Ladder Truck. Here comes the ladder truck. Woo! Check it out. Wow. Apparently. Holy cow! The balloon boy's here. Station 62 ladder truck. Good job, guys. Some kid's going to grab that and take off. But I think we'll be able to find him. North Metro Fire Rescue Paramedics, thank you. Saving John Ferraro's life here about 5 months ago when he had his heart attack. Ladies and gentlemen, our grand marshals, Karen McGuire and Peggy Atkinson. Karen McGuire started the Broomfield Depot Museum, was a project of the JC's, Bicentennial Project, in 1976. At that time, they relocated it to Depot Hill. Karen McGuire and her husband Wayne and her daughter Dawn worked so hard to make that a reality. And when she retired, Peggy Atkinson took over. And these two ladies are the reason we have the Depot Museum today. And we are so pleased to be honoring them as our grand marshals. Can we stay in line, will you? Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Karen McGuire and Peggy Atkinson, our grand marshals. The car they're in is driven by Paul Page in his 2005 Audi. Paul owns 24 UNet, providing telecom services to small businesses located at the Rocky Mountain Airport. Getting ready to celebrate their 10th anniversary. Thank you, Paul. And thank you, Karen and Peggy. Without them, we would not have a Broomfield Museum today. Please go up on the hill, Depot Hill. They do tours on, we have a director now, they do tours on Saturdays. They do children's tours from school. It's a wonderful education of Broomfield's history. We'd like to present them with these bouquets on behalf of the City and County of Broomfield and the Broomfield Optimist Club. Lee, put him back there. That's what I'm talking about. All right, ladies and gentlemen, your Mayor Pat Quinn, right up in front of the fire engine, and your city council members representing Ward 1, Bob Geiser and Todd Schumacher. The only little guy in the wagon would be his son Henry and his daughter's driving. Ward 2, Mike Shelton and Dennis McCloskey. Dennis, how's your brother Mike doing? Inside joke. Ward 3, Kevin Jacobs and Sam Taylor. Ward 4, Mayor Pro Tem Greg Stokes and David Juzak from Omni Hotel. Ward 5, Wayne Anderson and yours truly, Martha Durda. Hi, Annie. Hey, here's your Mayor Pro Tem with Maureen and the girls. Riding along with Sarah's Kevin Jacobs right there. And your former council person, Linda Reynolds, who's still quite an advisor to council. And the guy in the white hat, Steve Higgins, all-conference Broomfield High running back, went to North Dakota to play football, came back home, and his beautiful daughters are with him. Steve was one of the main sponsors of our run this morning. Steve, thanks for all your support. Steve Higgins. Ladies and gentlemen, the world-famous Legacy High School Lightning Marching Band went to London, England 2 years ago. Last year, they marched in the Macy's Day Thanksgiving Parade. Let's give it up for the Lightning Marching Band and Flag Band. Let's hear it for these flag kids, huh? Legacy High School Lightning Marching Band, the six-time 5A State Marching Band champions, six-time Broomfield Day sweepstake winners, and three-time state parade champs. They performed in the Macy's Day Thanksgiving Day Parade last year, as I mentioned, in New York City. The band would like to thank the parents, boosters, high school administration, and great citizens of Broomfield for their continued support.
Really? My favorite. We gotta go. Woo! I'm loving these parents and teachers, teaching them the really good music. The Kingsmen, 1962. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the Legacy High School Cheer Anthem. Legacy Cheer consists of 22 ladies coached by Robin Peterson, captained by Jordan Schroeder, co-captains Molly Hoff and Katie Murphy. Who's this kid coming in late? And here are the palms. Do you need us to hum or sing anything? Should we hum something for you? Okay. Oh, here we go. The 21 ladies and Pam placed third in state competition 2011 in baseball. Tammy Bergstrom and Jennifer Edwards. Their captain is Audrey Hedberg. Join them all. The games and events happening throughout the year. Let's give it up for the Palms and Cheer Squad.
I love the sound if we spend the night.
Golf tournament out at the Broadlands, and a foursome actually got struck by lightning. It was giving up a little too much for the school logo, but nobody was hurt, thank heaven. Good job, ladies. Thank you. Go Lightning! All right, let's give it up for the Broomfield Optimist Clown Contest winners. Your Broomfield Optimist Club sponsoring this for well over three decades. Started by Byron Roderick and Jack May. Old, old time Broomfield Optimists. Hi, clowns! How you doing? Well, do something funny! Come on! Oh, come on! Uh-oh, you better. I'm going to have Jim take back that ribbon. Good job. Jim Figg has chaired the Broomfield Optimist Clown Contest for 30 years. Elite Dance Academy is coming up. The Elite Dance Academy, please welcome the Elite Dance Academy All-Star Palms Team and Competitive Dance Team. Elite Dance provides dance classes for all ages and levels and is proud to announce they are celebrating their 10th anniversary, a decade of Elite Dance Academy. Thank you.
A sling here. Jimmy Reichert gone, not forgot. We love him. Good to see you, Danny. Cole Colts, everybody. Cindy Kyer, principal. And her husband, Harry, a pretty good golfer.
Good job, Colts. All right, friends of Broomfield. Oh, we still got Colts here. Oh, there's friends down there. Hi, ladies. How are you? A lot of hometown girls we watch grow up here, bringing their kids back to Cole. Thank you for putting the straw under the Colts. One of the reasons we have all the dancers early on is because we don't want them following the horses. Friends of Broomfield, Jennifer, is that you on that bicycle? Get over here and give me a hug. I love you so much. Let's hear it for Friends of Broomfield. Organization in Broomfield, Gina Koffel and all the gang. Friends of Broomfield Inc. is a nonprofit agency in Broomfield that provides services for adults with developmental disabilities. Earlier this month, we broke ground on our new building. The theme for this year's float is Building Our Future. Let's give it up for Friends of Broomfield. We love you all. They've got a talent show coming up, and from what I hear, we might have some real strange dancers. Like yours truly, and maybe a couple of people on stage here, if I can talk them into it. Ooh. And I love you. Yeah! September 28th, what time? 7 o'clock, Broomfield Audi. Woo! Let's give it up for Friends of Broomfield! You know what I just heard? It's a tribute to Michael Jackson. Really? How would I have guessed? I'm glad it's not OJ.
Really?
Only kidding. You know I love you. Dina, formerly AKA Paula Abdul from Jam. Hey, hey, hey! Hi, guys. I'm loving it. And my wife's gonna go, and how did you get that glitter on you? Okay. Front Range Barracudas! It's a Cudas! Cudas is a year-round USA swimming sanctioned competitive swim team. But Cudas believe in fun, friendly, and positive environment, emphasizing technique for the success of all swimmers. Vance Rasmussen used to be a swimmer, but he can't make a flip turn anymore. As a matter of fact, neither can I. Good job, Kudos! I'll tell you, nobody more dedicated than swimmers. Whew. Oh man, check out this truck. Ron Long picked up Marilyn for their first date in this truck right here. And she's from Kenosha, Wisconsin. So he had a full of bratwurst, eh? Hey, Bernie! Bernie! Hi, sweetheart. Backstory Theater presenting Pirates and Princesses and Poodle Skirts. Backstory is a nonprofit arts organization in Broomfield. They offer theater classes and performance opportunities for individuals of all ages. Go visit their booth to be a pirate or princess for Broomfield Days to learn more about their program. Check out their booth. Good job. Hey, let's see it from Elephant Man. Turn around. Show the crowd your snout there, buddy. Attaboy. Good job, Backstory Theater. Oh, look at our princess. Give us a wave, princess. Wave. Did mommy work on the wave? Good job, boys and girls, and pirates of all ages. Arr! Backstory Theater. Broomfield Academy! How warm is it in that outfit, huh, buddy? Woo-hoo-hoo! You betcha. Broomfield Academy! An independent
independent, nationally accredited private elementary middle school serving children from 2.5 to 14 years. Are you serious? 2.5, you want to start school? Oh, my Lord. The teachers provide individualized programming for all students, allowing them to become exceptional, accelerated, and creative students within small class sizes. Let's give it up for Broomfield Academy! Let's give it up for the lifeguard. He's been blowing that whistle for what? Like 3 miles.
Hi there. So what's your name?
Melanie.
Melanie, what school do you go to?
Broomfield High School.
Broomfield High. And how about you? What's your name?
Casey.
Hi, Casey. What school do you go to?
Broomfield High School.
And you, what's your name?
Rachel.
Oh, do you go to Broomfield High too? How many years have you been coming to the parade?
Since I was in elementary school for a while.
Yeah, we've all gotten together every year. I mean, we're best friends.
Kindergarten, yeah.
What is your favorite part of the parade?
Broomfield High School.
Of course. I love the part about the dogs, watching the dogs jump in that part. Interesting. I love it for hours. I love it.
Nice. How about you?
I love the dancing horses.
The dancing horses. Oh, my gosh. That's my favorite, too. Awesome. Well, have a wonderful parade. Thank you, ladies.
Cub Scout Pack 511! Look at this unicycle guy! My fault, my bad. Teaching our leaders of the future, Cub Scout Pack 511 helps our kids with the core values of life, including citizenship, cooperation, courage, respect, and responsibility. Activities include rock climbing, pinewood derby, and rocket launching. Rocket launching? In addition to the monthly meetings where children have fun and value life lessons, as well as unicycle lessons. Hey, the square dancers are here! Scootback Square Dance Dance Club! Dancing the official Colorado State Folk Dance! Woo-hoo! Everybody say woo-hoo! Once more, woo-hoo! Once more, woo-hoo! Square Dance features modern music and a caller who sings and calls the steps to the dancers. The colorful outfits are always a part of the dance. They host twice a month at Broomfield United Methodist Church. Join them for fun and friendship. You could be dancing this fall. Ask a dancer for more information. Is that J.C. Moore up there, our former councilman? Hello, J.C. Hi, guys. Good job, United Methodist Church. Don't fall off that thing.
Two ladies change back.
Broomfield High School Eagles marching down! Let's add flag corps. Let's give it up for the Eagles marching down! Thank you.
Let's give it up for the drummers! Yeah! Good job, Eagles! And while we're waiting for the Eagles Pop Squad and cheerleaders, I want to tell you, when Karen McGuire was bringing all the things up on the hill by the Depot Museum, she wanted the Parks Department to bring an outhouse from Joe Hutter's house. And I said, excuse me? She said, well, it has a weighted door and it has a rolling.
Hi there, what's your name?
Sierra.
Lou Sierra, what school do you go to?
Aspen Creek.
And how many parades have you been to?
I don't know how many.
How many parades have you been to?
Mostly the same thing as my sister been to.
And your sister is coming down now. She is a pom-pom, is that what you said?
Yeah.
For what school?
The Broomfield High School.
Oh, I think I see them coming. Well, it's so exciting. We'll have to watch her. Thank you so much.
Now, when we say we are Broomfield, we want to hear everybody in the crowd. Oh, sure. Oh, sure. We broke our ankle, did we? Don't you hate those aerials? Broomfield Palms! Woo-hoo! You know what's great? A lot of people I've watched grow up here in Broomfield are now here watching their kids and their grandkids. Right, Diedrich? Hey, you.
How are you? Good. You need that? Over there. I think. They're here, right?
Hey, well, Palms. Give it up for the Palm Squad!
Yeah, boy! I'm a sinner in dreams and flowers. sneak away to the Philippines. They still gon' take pictures of my derriere in the magazine. They want a piece of me.
Broomfield Bombs, that was awesome. You can see them every home game at halftime. Good job. Joe Butkovich, Vance, and I are all hurting from those kicks, aren't we? Holy cow. Oh, it's the homecoming candidates. Let's hear it for the homecoming candidates. My wife happened to be homecoming queen in 1960. They didn't invent cars yet. She rode in a little horse and buggy. Actually, she was, but they did have cars. Model Ts. Car number one, Alex Briggs and Andrew Dewey. Dewey, good job, Dewey. Car number two, driven by John Long. Hey, John, you want to borrow this hat? That's as close to a Mercedes as I'll ever get. John Long, your athletic director at Broomfield High School, driving the Mercedes. And Katie Kroll, oh, Katie. You've been working on that wave, haven't you, Katie? Catherine's dad is the girls' basketball team that took our team to 5 state championships. And, of course, Katie knows how to dribble well. And Evan Keehan Brown knows him. Good job. Good job, Evan, giving out candy, trying to get more votes. Oh, sure, no problem, man. No sweat. Just, if you can get between the two red cards, I think we can balance it out. Red, black, red, black. Okay, Evan, enough sucking up. Get back in the car. Good job. You guys hate Evan for that, don't you? In car number three, Kenzie Hacker. Ooh, I love the name Kenzie. And Dan Burst. Dan, great job on a gridiron, buddy. Keep up the good work. When you see your dad, tell him to get his ambulance out or they're going to tow it. He's blocking original pizza. Carmella's trying to get the pies over here. Hey, look who's in car number four. Annie Clark and Kevin Rinesmith, my favorite swimming coach. Kev, good job, buddy. Kev coaches over at the Swim and Tennis Club, swimming all summer. He's a great coach and a great young man. Good luck to all the homecoming candidates. Behind me is Mr. Tom Dielen Sr. Came out from Staten Island, New York 100 years ago, and he's still going strong. Tommy D. Sr. And if you want to hear somebody talk like this, just talk to Tommy D. What do we got? What do we got? The shark? How hot is it in there? This is a new weight loss program. They put you in this suit, walk you 3 miles in the hot sun. You're guaranteed to lose 30 pounds.
Hi there. And what's your name?
I'm Mike, and this is Ben.
Hi, Ben. How many parades has this little guy been to?
This is his second parade.
His second parade? High five.
He was here about 1 month.
Oh, my gosh. That's amazing. And who else are there, is here with you today?
My wife, his mom, Amy.
Hi. And what is your favorite part of Broomfield Days?
I'd say the parade, for sure.
The parade? It looks like it's his, too. Hi. Well, thank you so much. Enjoy your day.
People, wake up. It is so hot in that uniform. I have no idea. A smart car. Please do not run into the extended Hummer because it'll be not such a smart car. Are you part of the car wash deal? So is it like me getting a haircut, they could get a discount if they're riding that in? I would hope so. Half off, right? Absolutely. If you drive a smart car,
The car wash is half off. Kind of like Louis only charges me half for this haircut. Oh my goodness. We have a team pit a full. Advocating and promoting responsible dog ownership and community awareness through education and community outreach. We're trying to make pit bulls friendly, are we not? Yes, thank you. Very good. And they look like good guys and they are dying for some water. And that's a trained attack dog in the ballerina outfit, correct? I can see that. You're gonna have to pick her up to go on a fire hydrant up there. Hey, buddy, I'm loving the shades. Water, water, hi, how pretty are you? If that dog shed, save it for me. My hair was exactly that color, and I miss it, and that's the truth. Pony rides on this dog a little later in the afternoon right over by the bouncy castle. Thank you, dog owners everywhere. Do you think dog owners voted for America's Got Talent since the dog guys won, huh? Do we love our dogs? Absolutely. If my Chihuahua Maltese was here, she'd be barking at every one of you. Oh, look who's here, the princesses. Oh, yeah. Diamond Miss. I'm going to go into my Diamond Miss voice, okay? Hey, who's that good-looking lady? Is that Aretha's granddaughter driving that car? Give me a little respect, will you, young lady? Oh, thank you. And back at you. This is our Diamond Miss, the Colorado affiliate of the national organization of our Diamond Miss. Riding today are the national overall Baby Shiley state queens, Athena, Tahila, Ashley, Tegan, Michaela, and Ava. Find them on Facebook or ourdiamondmisspageants.com. Ladies, you are adorable. Give me this. Give me this. Oh, thank you. You are so good. By the time you become high school homecoming queens, you'll have that all down pat. Thank you, ladies. Thanks for being in our parade. Diamond Miss. Meridian Grade School! Meridian Elementary, the Meridian Mustangs are the top testing elementary in all of Adams County District 12, serving McKay Landing in the Broadlands. Hey, Trace, how you doing? There's my neighbor, Tracy. Hi, Tracy. Hey, Jimmy, Jimmy's pulling the float. Good job. These are my next door neighbors. Hey, Jimmy. Hey, Mitch, how you doing? Good job. Let's hear it for the Meridian Mustangs, whose principal has the best haircut in town. That dog's going, I've had enough. I'm done. Good job, Meridian Mustangs, serving McKay Landing and the Broadlands. The Broomfield Veterans Memorial Museum. You guys are veterans of what? Star Wars 2009? Okay. Broomfield Veterans Museum. Join them for coffee and conversation with local veterans in an informal setting. Listening to stories of service and sacrifice. Ask questions of your speakers and other veterans. Presentations start at 9 a.m. on September 22nd. October 6th, October 13th, October 27th. Visit their website for a list of upcoming speakers, programs, and events. If you want to learn about all the wars, and especially World War II, Korea, Vietnam, please go over and enjoy what your veterans have to say. There they are, Jimmy! Hey, Bob Davis, one of the many Bob Davises in town, my old State Farm agent. Jimmy, good to see you. And these guys have some great stories to tell. Service to our country. We love you guys. Thank you for your service. Great job. Great job. Thank you. Our Veterans Memorial Museum is right here up here at number 12. Number 12, Garden Center. If you want to learn about the Veterans of War, please go and listen to these wonderful stories. We had Paul Murphy, a survivor of Indianapolis, come down before the parade. Paul, a true American war hero. He was 18 years old when the Indianapolis was hit by torpedoes, by Japanese torpedoes. He was in the Pacific Ocean for 4.5 days. And over 1,100 were sunk. Only 300 and some survived. And it's unbelievable. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you to our service. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you for our service to our country. Appreciate it. Do you have any K rations left in that Jeep? Yeah, but they don't taste so good. They're a little stale. Whoa, sweet honey. Broomfield Farmers Market at Holy Comforter Episcopal Church. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Woo! Northern Colorado's favorite farmers market every Tuesday. Located on Highway 287 and 10th Avenue on Tuesday afternoons from 4 to 7 through September 25th. Their mission is to create a destination in Broomfield to connect residents with healthy food and local farmers. All proceeds are donated to outreach programs in Broomfield. Last year's beneficiaries were Fish, a local food bank. So let's give it up for our Episcopal Holy Comforter Episcopal Church's Farmers Market. Oh, yeah. The Broomfield Lions Club would like to announce that today is Rose and Tony Sarno's 61st anniversary. 61st wedding anniversary for Tony and Rose Sarno. And their son Dale and a lot of their kids are very involved in Broomfield yet today.
Hi there, and what's your name?
Lori Keel.
Lori Keel, and this is your son?
Terry Keel.
Terry, and your daughter?
Mandy Keel.
Mandy Keel, nice to meet you all. We have three generations of Broomfield attendees.
This is Arthur.
This is Arthur.
Hi, Arthur.
And this is Annie.
Hi, Annie. Now, I hear the two of you were both in the parade. What did you do in the parade?
When I was in high school, I marched with the Horizon Marching Hawks for 3 years.
That's amazing. And what'd you play?
I played in the drum line, bass drum and cymbals and such.
That's wonderful. And how about you? When you were in the marching band, what instruments did you play?
I played trombone, tuba, and saxophone, different years depending.
That's incredible. Multi-talented here. Well, it's wonderful to have you here. Three different generations of Broomfield Days attendees.
Right? Absolutely. Good job, Birch. Bulldogs. Cub Scout Pack 545, based at Meridian and Coyote Ridge Elementary Schools. Pack 545 is one of the largest and most active Cub Scout packs in the Denver area. This pack enjoys hitting targets with arrows, blow darts, and paintballs. I want to join this pack. My mother would never let me do that. You guys don't aim at anybody's eyes. No. Well, see, this guy's got safety glasses on. Good. Oh, man, that sounds like fun. I want to join Pack 545. Woo! The Hunger Games. So we would be the Flyers, ladies? The City of Broomfield Gymnastics and Broomfield Flyers for ages 7 to 18 at the Palm River Recreation Center. They compete with other recreation centers around the state, and they are the very best Flyers! Good job, Flyers! Are you serious? Somebody took your car battery away. Korean War veterans, Denver, Queen City, honoring all military personnel who fought in the Korean War. These guys were there, they came back, and somebody took their Jeep body away from them. Korean War veterans, 1950-1953, 60th anniversary. Thank you guys, thank you for your service to our community. I'm glad it's not breezy today, guys. I've heard about this, kids. Yeah, we don't want to go there. Hey, George, George and Eddie Brandt in the back of the float. Hi, guys. George, one of the longest cancer survivors in Broomfield. Good job, George. Annie, we love you, darling. Korean War veterans, ladies and gentlemen. My dad was recalled here in Korea. That's how I ended up in Kansas from Connecticut. And they thought I was from another planet because I said, Ka and Quada. What's that about? Oh, this is why we don't have the dancers behind the prancing horses. This is the American Lady Riders, and look at you. How pretty are you?
I don't know. The horse looks better, I think.
Oh, my goodness. How gorgeous. American Lady Riders. Here's a group of women that love everything about horses. They ride often for any number of causes and benefits. Today, they ride to honor our American servicemen and women. Our service members' bravery and willingness to stand up for this wonderful country has allowed the American Lady Riders to continue the freedom to pursue their passion for horseback riding. They wish to say thanks, and God bless our troops, and God bless America, and God bless you, ladies. Good job. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh, my goodness. Gorgeous. And here's the most important person. Pick me up, Millie. We are having a horse chip throwing contest later in front of the main stage.
Hi there. So I'm here with three individuals who ran the 5K. Tell me your name.
Jackson Full.
And yours?
Sophie Full.
Sophie Kelly.
Well, congratulations on completing it. How did it feel?
It was kind of tiring because, well, this is my first 5K, so it's kind of hard. I started off pretty fast, but then I slowed down after a while, so, yeah.
Well, it's quite an accomplishment. Congratulations. And how about you?
It was really hard. It was just really hard.
That's okay. 5K is a long way to go, but you did it, so that's awesome. Congratulations. And how was it for you?
It was a good way to start off Saturday, so it was fun. It was a good time. It was good to run with her, so.
Awesome. Well, congratulations, and have a great rest of your Broomfield days. Thanks.
Broomfield Republican Women's in Broomfield for over 50 years. They sponsor many community activities, Relay for Life, Fish, the library, and fund their own Pat Walters Memorial Scholarship Program. Pat was a long time, hey, Pat Johnson right there. Hey, Pat. Pat Walter was a longtime Broomfield Republican woman. Karen, hi Karen, and passed away last year and set up a scholarship fund in her memory. Hey, how are you, Linda? Linda Feigl. Broomfield Republican women, Broomfield Republicans, veterans. Whoa, look at that truck. Romney, Colorado. You built that truck yourself? Is that why you're wearing a blue shirt? He said cautiously. Dave Piggott! Dave Piggott running for House District 33. Ann Thatter, Board of Education. Her husband's cousin Tom, a longtime Broomfield resident, singing in the Nativity Choir. Lundberg for Congress. Vicki Marble! Vicki Marble, Senate District 23. Where's Vicki? She's my backup singer. Where is she?
Right there.
Where's that sexy thing? Hey, hey! Oh, and here's her lookalike right here. Who gets most of the hug Vicky's looking for? The Reagan Club, Ronald Reagan, Reagan Club of Colorado. founded to continue the legacy of Ronald Reagan's smaller government, lower taxes, and more personal freedoms. The club's purpose is to support candidates with these same conservative views, the Ronald Reagan Club. Dave Piggott. Dave, don't fall off that thing. Dave Piggott. Dave's a West Point graduate running for District 33, House District 33. And look at it, it's Mary Poppins. Oh my God. Dave Piggott, House District 33. Try not to hurt anybody. There he is, there he is. Good job, buddy. Mary Poppins. Hey, Shay, how you doing? This was actually part of the Veterans Museum. It broke down by Nativity Church. AAA came out and got that machine gun loaded. Dave Piggott, West Point graduate, served in Iraq, running for House District 33. Yes, that's a thing. Vicky Marble. That's an inside joke. Singing at bumpers. Jeff, is that Iris under the umbrella? Hi, Iris. Jeff Ozerman running for RTD board. Jeff's been at every function supporting RTD board. Jeff's a good candidate. Jeff's a West Point graduate and a cancer survivor like myself. Jeff, good to have you here. And his lovely wife, Iris. While we have a break, I just want to once again thank Karen McGuire and Peggy Atkinson, our Grand Marshals this year. Without their dedication, we would not have a Broomfield Museum up on Depot Hill. And sitting next to Karen.
Hi there. So what's your name?
Lauren.
Hi, Lauren. Are you having a good Broomfield Day?
Yes.
What's been your favorite part of the parade so far?
The Broomfield Flyers, because my friend's in the Broomfield Flyers.
And they did gymnastics, is that right?
Apple Tree Christian.
Awesome. And who are you here today at the parade with?
Where every child is
I'm with my mom and my sister.
Staff is back there. The whole child.
So you're here with your family and you're enjoying your day?
Class sizes for maximum individual attention.
Good. Well, it's nice talking with you. Have a wonderful parade.
Ages 2 and a half to 6 years. Okay. Boogie on down to Apple Tree, located at 10th and Daphne. In Broomfield United Methodist Church. Well, boogie on down, boogie on down. Boogie on down to Apple Tree, yeah, yeah. Okay. Woo! Look at those poodle skirts. Yeah. I'll tell you, the Methodist Church is rocking out. Hi. Can you dance for me? Oh, yeah, you can. I know you can. I love your shoes. Oh, those are beautiful. I love that dress. American flag, show everybody, do one of these. That's wonderful, thank you. Oh yeah, look at those apple skirts. Okay, grab a hold of a railing, bye, love you. Ooh. Everybody check out the little one picking her nose, I love it, I love it. Oh, are you eating a boogie? That's okay, when I was your age, I did too. I love you. Thank you, bye. Hey, has Broomfield, Colorado got the most adorable kids in the world or what? Tommy, doing good, buddy. We do have the best looking kid. Hey, what do we got here? The Lime Green Club? Kid Harmony Marching Band! A homeschool family marching band from Fort Lupton. entire family participates and enjoys marching in parades throughout the summer. Good job! What's that noise? Oh, it's the kids next door, the Kids Harmony Band. The bass sounds so good. Broomfield Assembly of God. They didn't tell you guys the parade route was that long, did they? Broomfield Assembly of God, the King's Kids. Ooh, yeah. Amen to that. They have worked with the community using the arts to bring awareness to kid trafficking. A community working together for a cause. Everyone has gotten involved. Home Depot, King Supers, Habitat for Humanity. Neighbors and friends, stop by their tent west of Cole for their kids' art table and more information. Let's give it up for Broomfield Assembly of God, the King's Kids. Let me see it. Emerald Elementary School, the Dragons! The Elementary School Dragons! These students use the word fire to stay focused on learning at school. Fire stands for focus, integrity, respect, empathy. Fire! This summer, the Emerald community came together to build a school garden that serves as an outdoor learning lab about science, nutrition, and the natural world. Go, Dragons! Okay, a trivia question. How would they come up with the name Fire? Would it have anything to do with dragon breath? Yeah! Oh, man, check out this guy's hair. I wish I could do that. You know what? No matter how much gel I use, I can't get mine to do that. I love it, buddy. Good job. Hey, come over here. Give me knuckles. Check out this guy's hair, huh? Woo! Oh, baby, come over here and give me a kiss. Oh. What a set of lips. Diedrich, you're going to love this, baby. Hey, Paul Straub, the engineer. And is that good-looking lady in the purple hair? Get a kiss. Annie, you got your grandkid over there. Good job. Well, is that a set of lips or what? Fun Services, bringing fun to Broomfield. And the entire Front Range for over 30 years, locally owned and operated. They're your one-stop shop for all your party needs. Specializing in company picnics, casino night, catering services, and is Broomfield's premier Halloween superstore. Located 123rd year-round, open 7 days a week year-round. Fun Services, everybody. Remember to get your Fun Service stuff on Vance Rasmussen's birthday on Halloween. Oh, look who's here, our Little Miss Colorado royalty. Hi, lady. Oh, have we been practicing our waves or what? And our kiss blowing. Colorado, our Little Miss of 2012, our Little Miss pageant royalty. Kisses. to the crowd. Let's give it up for our Little Miss Colorado royalty. Great job, ladies. Melissa Jones is in charge of our parade every year. Melissa, stand up. If it wasn't for Melissa Jones and her dad, Joe, we would not be here today, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it up for Melissa. Live, love, dance. Boy, those are my words. Live, love, dance. Words to live by. Offering ballet, tap, jazz, lyrical, musical, theater, proms, and father-daughter classes here in Broomfield. They focus on presenting dance in a non-competitive setting and using dance to help others. Come by the studio next week and take a free class during your free week of dance. Betty Harms, I'm signing you up for this class. Boy, those dance women look good forever, you know? Words to live by. Come over here. You are too cute. I said that last year. I go, are you a Chicago girl? She goes, no, I'm New York. And man, is she sweaty, but it smells so good. Never forget. We will never forget. Frank J. Carroll Detachment reflects the flag raising on Iwo Jima. This float is to honor all veterans who lost their lives in service to our country. Amen to that. Followed by Daniel Metzger Mule, an M274 mule used in the Vietnam War. Was also researched and tested for a moon rover at one time. They're a highly prized and rare collectible U.S. military vehicle. God bless all those who served in the wars, those we lost in Iwo Jima. Iwo Jima! Semper Fi, guys, Semper Fi. Anywhere. They are devoted to their craft, measured in smiles, stop by Scooters on Highway 287 between McDonald's and Taco Bell. It's a little tiny place. I want to know, where do you guys go to the bathroom?
Oh, in a little tinier place.
In a little tiny room, in a little tiny house. In a little tiny empty coffee cup. He didn't say that. Go, Scooters. Have you got a routine for us? Did you bring a vanilla latte for me? Oh, what are you guys? Oh, you're chippers.
We are.
Oh, so you're going to be bowled over by the car or just by the chipmunk? Chipper's Lane, where Broomfield families come for fun and entertainment. Chipper's Bowling Center offers a... Oh, am I going to get bowled over? Oh, that could be dangerous. Chipper's Bowling Center offers a smoke-free environment with automatic scoring, a full-service bar, restaurant, and arcade for your enjoyment. Chipper's is locally owned and located at 100 Nickel Street. For more information on leads, events, parties, and specials, visit your website or our website at chipperlanes.com. Now remember, the best part about Chippers, they have the bars come up so you can never get a gutter ball. So it's without question my favorite bowling alley. Somebody wake up Betty. We have more parade left. Whoa! Nativity Knights! Bless yourself! Holy mackerel!
Hi there, and what's your name?
Kate.
Kate, and what school do you go to?
Academy.
Are you having fun at Broomfield Days?
Yes.
Your face looks so pretty. What is your favorite part of the parade?
Candy and face paint.
Well, your face looks pretty, and we've gotten a little bit of candy. Are you ready to watch the rest of the parade and have a great day?
Yes.
Awesome. Well, thanks for talking with me.
Oh, there's Riley. There's Maddie over there. Hi, guys. Okay, we're going to do it in memory of Father Mac. Are you ready? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Oh, Father Mac, amen to that. And we miss Father Mac. We lost him to cancer several years ago. He was the best. He could do, and it took him just that long, and I do it good, don't I? Because I listen. And I can do a little Irish, but I can't do the Italian thing anymore. You know? Well, I can if I do it with this. I'm going to talk to you during the homily, and thank you very much. And there's Dana's mom, who looks like her older sister, actually. Grandma, good job, Nativity Knights! God bless! The Nativity Knight horse is one from the Three Margaritas. And good luck, Knight! We miss our Father Mac. God bless! Where's Father Michael? I saw him going to church at 7 this morning. He was doing an early mass. Oh, he's with the bishop. Uh-oh. Oh, look at you guys, the nativity scene. Thank you. We want you to put on some long underwear. We're going to pack that in front of the church at Christmas, right?
Okay.
Is that a real baby?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Baby Jesus.
Hey, Phil, how are you? Oh, look at these guys, huh? I knew these guys when they were young. That guy when he had hair, and I did too. Phil's was dark. Dennis's was dark. There you go. The Knights of Columbus, everybody. Serving the community. Hey, Chuck. Good to see you, buddy. They didn't tell you the route was that long, did it? Hey, Dennis. Dennis Eichner. This is longer than your mail route, isn't it? Oh, Kathleen. Peters, Miss Colorado Junior High 2012. Thank you for being in our parade. Oh, I've got a long thing here for you. Miss Colorado Junior High and High School Collegiate Pageant. The pageants exist for the purpose of providing personal and professional opportunities for young women in junior high, high school, and college. The High School Collegiate Pageants provide scholarships to help young women achieve their goals while providing a forum for personal growth. Kathleen, congratulations. Oh, my goodness, Susan. Is that Mike behind you? He's looking pretty good, actually. Okay, you're scaring me now. What's up with this? No kidding. Joe goes the Freight Man. I'm going, no kidding. The Freight Man compound. Two of Colorado's scariest haunted houses at one location. 108th and Old Wadsworth in West Minster. Open every night in October. Boy, I'm going to rush right over there, especially for the guy with the axe. For more information, visit thefrightmare.compound.com. Hello, gorgeous. Hey, go over and kiss that girl in the white blouse over there, would you? On the end. Yeah, right on the end of the front row. Over here. No, a little, yeah, to your right, over there. Yeah, the one with the pink thing in front of her face. She's a really good kisser and a great laugher. That's the one. Thank you. Buddy Harms. Oh. Hey, Hatchet Man. Don't get anywhere near. Buddy, you always said you like guys with pointed ears. Okay. Do you have any commercials? Any commercials? My name's Paul Duda, and I approve of this parade. Thank you very much. And on behalf of the City and County of Broomfield, the Recreation Division, the Parks Department, the Police Department, and our Fire Rescue District, thank you all for being here. Be safe. Hang on to your kids. If you lose your kids, we're at the last kid booth right behind our information booth, right behind the reviewing stand here.
Hi there, ladies. What's your name?
Haley.
Becca.
And I just heard a story that you were supposed to be in the parade, but something happened. You were supposed to be with Aspen Grove, but what happened?
I was doing cartwheels for my school and the front of the flags, and my principal came up and told me that I couldn't do that and that it wasn't a performing thing, so that I couldn't be in the parade.
So I think you're the first people I've ever met that got kicked out of being in a parade for doing cartwheels, for showing spirit. Well, besides that, what's been your most exciting part of your day?
Well, when we were coming back from when we got kicked out, we got chased by a zombie person, and it was very creepy.
So you got kicked out of a parade and then chased by a zombie. Sounds like a very, very exciting Broomfield Days. Yeah. Well, thank you, ladies. Have a great day.
You too.
Hey, good. School varsity cheer squad. Excuse me, ladies. Last weekend, the cheerleaders competed in the Spirit Fest in Lee Elitch Gardens. Last night, they cheered on the Mighty Hawks against North Glen High School. These cheerleaders proudly support the Hawk Nation. Let's give it up for the Hawks. Well, we're going to have Kathy, nice tan. We're going to have Karen McGuire and Peggy Atkinson stand for this one, because we would not have these people in the parade, and we would not have a Depot Museum if it wasn't for these two ladies. So.
So what's your name?
My name is Chris.
Hi, Chris, and how many Broomfield Days have you been to?
This is my first one.
Your first one. What do you think so far?
It's long. It's very long. They need to coordinate and bring it together a little bit.
Okay, yeah, it is a little bit long. But besides the length, of what has been your favorite part?
Gosh, I don't know. I think the bands. I like the music. I like the gals with the flags. I do like the bands a lot. I wish I could see a majorette or two, but I haven't seen one today.
Yeah, no, I don't think I have either. Well, thank you for talking with me. Enjoy the rest of your parade. It looks like it shouldn't be too much longer. Okay, thank you.
In Denver. Shep stayed there and was a guide, helped the toll takers. He was adopted by them. He was buried in the intersection. So many church and school groups wanted to go see his grave. It became a danger. So these lovely ladies made sure that it was relocated, and we had to deal with it. I had to deal with the highway department and everybody else. Shep's grave's relocated up on Depot Hill by the Depot Museum. Shep was a wonderful dog, and his history is in the museum itself. Show everybody the skirts, ladies. Those are awesome. The Depot Museum is located in Zanesburg Park, is open every Saturday from 12 to 3. They'll even be open today, maybe just a little late. So there we go. Thank you for all your service. Broomfield Depot Museum. Celebrated. It was relocated from the grain elevator in 1976, our bicentennial year, over to Depot Hill, and preserved as a depot museum. It was at the railroad tracks from 1909. 3 years ago, we celebrated the 100th anniversary of the Depot Museum. Thank you, ladies, thank you. And we would not have a Depot Museum if it weren't for our two grand marshals today, Karen McGuire and Peggy Atkinson. Thank you, ladies, oh, thank you. Thank you. Great job. Thank you. Get over and see the Depot Museum. Old Seth Patterson over there running for the RTD board. Hey, Seth. Longtime Broomfield resident. Hey, hey! Thank Al's family, Depot Museum. Aspen Creek Coyotes! K through 8, Aspen Creek Elementary School. Just a little northeast of the Markle homestead. Aspen Creek, oh, look at the unicycles. Good job, ladies. Hey, that looks like a four-wheel drive to me. What's up with that? Aspen Creek, K through 8, the Coyotes are out in force to show off their paw pride. The Aspen Creek community rewards students for positive, responsible, inclusive, dependable, engaged behavior in our everyday lives. Give a howl! Woo! For the Aspen Creek Coyotes and their paw pride. Let's give one more howl! Because the coyotes are all around there. Every night I take my little dog out in the backyard, and she doesn't stay out there very long. And I don't leave her alone. And nor should you, right? Coyotes, one more howl. Ow! Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Good job, coyotes. Get some sunscreen on Dad's head. I got it on mine. I wish I had hair like that, any color. Good job, coyotes. Ooh, I like your shirt, man. Judy LeBeau for RTD board. Hey, Judy. Where's Judy? There's Judy. Hi, Judy. There you go, Judy. Judy LeBeau for RTD board.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good.
Boy Scouts of America offering three programs. One for boys 11, or 7 to 11 called Cub Scouts.
Boy Scouts for boys 12 to 18 and Venturing for boys and girls 14 to 21 years old. Scouting is a worldwide activity and over 100 years old. To find a unit in your area, go to scout.com. Boy Scouts of America. Hey, Matt, how you doing? Where's Sammy? Ah, okay.
This is a repeat after me song. So say what I say. And do as I do. I said a boom, chicka boom.
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 I said a boom, shake a boom. Good job, guys. It's more fun with friends badge, okay? Uh-huh. Oh, this would be the Scout guys. Woo! Oh, yeah. Kevin Lundberg, David Pickett. That must have broken down too, huh? You're kind of behind them, but good job, buddy. We're glad you're here. We the people. Go, baby. Woo! I said a boo, shakabow. Don't hurt me. What do we got? Avalanche? K-S-E, Colorado Avalanche, Denver Nugget mascots, Rocky of the Avalanche and Bernie with the Nuggets. Wooly from the Mammoth may be there too. Wooly didn't make it. The heat was too much for him. We appreciate it. Did some hockey guy check somebody into that windshield? That would be my guess. Good job, ladies. Good job. Thanks for being here. Oh, Rocky, the best mascot in America, ladies and gentlemen. The reason that got in the Nuggets game. Rocky, we love you, baby. You are the best. Do not fall off that. We love you. You are the best mascot in all of America. And we are so honored to have you here at Broomfield. Broomfield Days 2012. Give it up for Rocky. Originally from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Good job, Rick. Rocky, let's give it up for Rocky. Watch this. Don't hurt yourself. Or even more important, don't hurt me. Give it up. Ha, 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 ha. Go, 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 go. Oh, but close. Okay, as many as you need, buddy. You're the best. Go, 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 go. Oh. Line up on that street thing. Here we go. Go, Rocky, go. Go, 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 go. Oh, a little short. But we're so happy you're here, man. As many as you need. The Rolling Dolls might have something to say about that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh. That's okay. Do a layup. Do a layup. You know, you look like me putting in a Broomfield Days golf tournament yesterday. We love you, Rocky. We love you, baby. Give it up for the best mascot in all of America, Rocky! And let's hear it for the Rollerbats! Woo! Get your tickets! They're at the First Bank Center. If you want to see some nasty rollerblading, you want to check out the Roller Dolls. Woo! A lost art, but we found again in America and in Broomfield, Colorado, with the First Bank Roller Dolls. Denver Roller Dolls. Denver's premier women's roller derby league and proud to be a part of one of the fastest growing women's sports in the nation. Catch them at the First Bank Center tonight at 7 p.m. And look who we have here, Dance Art Studio, Dancing in Broomfield. Dancing in Broomfield for over 50 years. They offer classes in ballet, tap, jazz, modern, lyrical, point, and pilates, or pilgrims pilots. The studio is under the direction of Heidi Thomas, who grew up in Broomfield, who was originally Heidi's senator, who studied under my wonderful Jane Spain. Originally started by Jane, I register now for fall classes. Over 50 years of dance in Broomfield, everybody. Let's give it up for Dance Art Studio. Studio started by Jane Spain, continued by Heidi Thomas. 50 years of dance in Broomfield, over three generations. Great job, ladies. Hey, look who's here. Good morning, Broomfield Democrats. Marching today are State Senate candidate Lee Kemp, State School Board candidate Angelica Schroeder, RTD candidate Cheryl Hager, and right out in front, Broomfield's own Diane Primavera, candidate for State House. Also marching are volunteers and staff for President Obama and Congressman Jared Polis. Let's hear it for the Broomfield Dogs. Hey, Chris. Hey, Diane. Diane Primavera, the only candidate they named an Italian dish after. She's got the recipe right here. Hi, guys. Broomfield County Democrats, Kemp. Couldn't you find a bigger sign? No. Diane Primavera! Woo. Cheryl Hager! Woo. Cheryl! Woo. Councilman Bob Geiser! Hey guys, how you doing? Hey Dennis! Dennis McCloskey! Barely! Look at this kid, huh? Hey, look who's here! It's the South Iron Ford guy, Joe Jackson! Woo! Yeah! South Iron Motors! You guys look good in those red shirts, man. Marching right behind the Democrats' blue shirts. What's up with that? Where's the bow man? Is he working?
He's out of
there. Oh, there he is. I knew there was a reason you guys were carrying basketballs. Silta Air Motors in Broomfield for over 50 years. They start, Aero Suds Accessories. Silta Air Motors started in 1960, the year I graduated from high school. Jack wasn't even born yet. Good to see you. Jack DeHaar Jr., everybody. Silta Air Motors. Started by his grandfather, followed by his father. Now Jack Jr.'s got it. Freddy! Get a hat on! You're killing me! I hope you've got sunscreen on that head. Is that car solar powered? Freddy White with a solar powered Mustang! Woo! Do not wreck that car. You will be in so much trouble. Silta Air Motors, serving Broomfield for over 50 years, supporting the foundation, youth sports, many, many activities over the years. Silta Air Motors. Elgin Street Sweepers, supporting your clean streets every week. Hey guys, good job.
All right, I'm here with Mary Jane. And Mary, how many Broomfield parades have you been to?
52. This is the 52nd.
I think you take the cake for the person that's been to the most parades that I've met today. And what's your favorite part?
Oh, I think the parade, probably.
The parade?
Yeah. It isn't as nice as it used to be because we used to have so many more floats, you know? And the kids stayed up all night working on them. That's when napkins were cheap. You know, they could build a float from napkins.
When napkins were cheap and they could put them all over their float and stay up all night making them.
They had fun. They really did.
And you just shared with me before now that you actually missed one parade, and the only reason you did was why?
Because I stayed up all night with the kids making a float on our lawn. And I was too tired.
Well, sure.
I think that the kids had a lot of fun, so that was worth me missing the float.
Of course, that's always worth it.
Yeah. So anyway, I hope I can have another good Broomfield Days.
That's wonderful. And I bet 52 years ago, you probably knew every single person at the parade.
Just about. And they probably were looking for anything and everything that they could do that day or the 4 days that we had.
Because it used to be 4 days.
Yeah. Thursday night was the firemen's fight, water fight.
Oh, how fun.
And then the watermelon eating, not a contest, but just coming here to eat watermelon. I don't know where they got the watermelons, but we ate a lot of them.
Well, unfortunately, I don't think there's a watermelon eating session this Broomfield Days, but it sure has been a fun one. Have you had a great day?
Yeah, I have. I got here early, like I always do, about 7:30.
Oh, wow, that is early.
Well, I like to see the clown contest.
The clown contest, oh, yeah. Sure.
My great-granddaughter's in it. But most of the kids ask them what their favorite subject was in school, and they always said on the playground.
Well, sure, whose favorite subject wasn't recess? That was always the best. Yeah. Well, Mary Jane, thank you so much. Nice talking with you. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Thank you. Well, we have another successful Broomfield Days 2012. And after such a traumatic summer, Colorado, we've had with all the wildfires and with the Aurora shooting, it's so nice to be able to end our summer on such a positive note with community, everyone coming together and showing their spirit, showing their love and compassion for each other. We couldn't have ended the summer in a better way with Broomfield Days. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you next year.